Hello, everyone. Today, I want to talk about mental barriers holding us back as entrepreneurs. So, there are people who get into entrepreneurship in different ways. I, for example, got into entrepreneurship because I have always been unable to hold a job. I'm always questioning the boss, and if I don't like it, then I question it some more. And bosses don't like that. And I'm always also thinking of ideas where in how I can improve this or improve the other one, or I'm looking at business opportunities. So in other ways, I couldn't do anything other than entrepreneurship. Now, there are other people, other group of people who go into entrepreneurship because of necessity. Maybe they lost their job that they've been holding for a while, and then they cannot find something similar, so they start their own business. Or the kind of people that need time flexibility, and they need to make a living in a way that allows them also to take care of their families or whatever other constraints that they have in their life. Anyway, so when we go into the field of entrepreneurship, we usually have two kinds of barriers. The exterior barriers, and this could be things as financing, lack of know-how, and let's say not knowing how to do a website or not knowing how to best distribute your product or service to your clients. So these are things that in a way can be hired away. Consultants can help us, and we can overcome those barriers. But I think there is one important barrier, and this one is the interior barriers. And more in particularly, there is the lack of self-confidence. It's a huge barrier. And another one is the scarcity mindset. Okay, so I like to look at the lack of self-confidence for a second. So I hear this all the time, and I just roll my eyes whenever I hear it. I hear one person saying to the other one, oh, all you have to do is believe in yourself, have self-confidence. Sure, as if this is something that we can just close our eyes and all of a sudden by inspiration of the divine, we're going to have self-confidence. No, self-confidence is earned. And I give you an example. Let's say that I have a child and he's learning how to ride a bicycle. Okay? I cannot tell my child, oh, all you have to do is believe in yourself and you're going to be able to ride that bicycle, you know, all day long. No. This child is going to learn by trying, by being willing to fail, by being willing to fall down and scrape his or her knees and then getting up and doing it again. And after he has done it 100 times, then he's going to be able to get on that bicycle and he's going to feel self-confidence that he's going to be able to ride to the park and back without any problem. And I will not have to tell him, oh, just believe in yourself. No, action preceded self-confidence. And this is something that it has to happen in our business environment as well. We just don't create a huge business. We start with a little business first, and then it grows, and so on and so forth. And we build our confidence by doing this, by failing, by trying different methods, and what gives. So confidence is not something that you obtain from the divine power. It's something that you get by trying and being willing to fail and be willing to accept your imperfections until your product or service is good enough to ship and to create that satisfaction in the client. The other mental roadblock that I see all the time is the scarcity mindset. Oh, everyone is already doing this. Everyone is already selling shoes online. Everyone already has a dentist. Everyone already has an accountant. So you know what? If you provide a good service, product or service, there are plenty of clients for you out there. And you know, I hear this all the time. You have to differentiate yourself. You have to be unique. You have to develop a niche, a part of the market that is haven't been serviced by anybody else. No, you can be just another vanilla entrepreneur, and you will have plenty of people knocking on the door. As far as I know, my car mechanic does not try to differentiate himself from other car mechanics. He just offers a service for a reasonable price, and that's it. And my dentist, he is not going to be unique in his service. No, he's just doing the same root canal as everybody else, and I don't expect him to do anything different. So if you have this scarcity mindset, let me tell you that you have to switch it for an abundance mindset. There are plenty of clients out there. If you just offer a good service, a good product or service, and you deliver on your promise, people will come to you. Maybe at first it will take a little bit of time to be known, but people will flock to you as long as they are getting value for their money. So that's it, my friend. Those are the mental mindset holding back most entrepreneurs. Just a lack of belief and self-belief, and having a scarcity mindset. And as you can see, you can get started, and as you get started, you develop that confidence. And as far as the scarcity mindset, all we have to know is that there are plenty of clients out there. There is plenty for everyone. So now, let me know, what is holding you back? Are you maybe a perfectionist? Are you suffering from the comparison trap? Are you the kind who scroll to Instagrams and see everybody else who is doing better than you? Or are you the kind that have the imposter syndrome? Tell me which one of these things is holding you back and what can be done to overcome it. Thank you so much for listening, and talk to you next week.